What's up guys, Sal here. So there's quite a hype surrounding Google's upcoming flagship phones, the Pixel 6 and Pixel 6 Pro. And rightfully so, because these handsets mark Google's comeback into a proper flagship segment. After stumbling around in the dark, experimenting with bathtub notches and gimmicks like squeezable sides and Sony radar motion gestures, Google appears to have some big things in store for the Pixel 6 Pro. Now, recently I made a video about how Google is planning to take on Samsung with the Pixel 6 by keeping a marketing budget in similar levels as to what Samsung keeps for their Galaxy S series of handsets. In the video, I've also talked about some of the specifications of the Pixel 6 and Pixel 6 Pro, but I forgot to mention one key feature, and it's about stereo speakers. Only the Pixel 6 Pro will have stereo speakers, one at the earpiece and another at the bottom. The regular Pixel 6 will only have one bottom speaker. With that being said, right now an ideal smartphone design would be where phone makers can stuff the front-facing camera under the display so that they won't have to deal with any sort of notch, camera cutouts, pop-up cameras, and so on. For a while now, many companies have been working on this technology, and a couple of these companies have managed to launch a commercial product as well that doesn't really do a great job at taking good front-facing photos. First, this is something that Google is working on as well, and LetsGoDigital has come across a patent by Google that shows the company's approach to this problem, which honestly is kind of genius in my opinion. You see, in most cases, the selfie camera is positioned in a similar way to the punch hole selfie camera, just with a tiny secondary display panel over the top, so it can be hidden when not in use. Here though, the selfie camera lens doesn't actually point towards you. Instead, the display has a little window in it with a mirror underneath. As you can see in the diagram, what's happening here is that the patent suggests the use of an under-display window, but instead of the camera being placed under the window, there's a prism or a mirror. This prism can flip to the left or right, with the left side featuring the actual camera and the right a secondary display. This means that when the camera is not in use, the prism will project a secondary display onto the main display's front camera cutout and give the impression that it is one continuous and uninterrupted display panel. But when the camera is needed, it will flip to reflect images onto the camera for it to capture. Both the main and secondary screens are OLED panels with the same pixel density, so they should allow for a seamless viewing experience. Honestly, this is by far the best solution for the under-display camera. The main problem associated with the conventional under-display tech is the lack of enough light on the front camera sensor. The light must pass through the display before falling onto the camera sensor, resulting in degraded image quality, which might explain why the tech isn't mainstream yet. But Google's approach is superior because the light doesn't have to pass through the display. The mirror will cleverly deflect the light to make it happen. Of course, we'll not see this on the Pixel 6 this year, but it's more than likely the Pixel 7 might have the under-display camera technology, and mirror deflection is what Google might use to make it happen. Of course, do consider subscribing for all the latest tech news, and as always, I'll see you tomorrow. Peace out.